Hey Sagittarius. Oh, geez, I'm so ahead of the game today. Energy, thank you. So Sagittarius, we're taking a look ahead to April. Now, it's not that April isn't without also its confusing energy. Well, not really confusing, but we do have Mercury retrograde till the end of the month. And but from what I hear, it's going to be a very healing Mercury retrograde. I love that. I love that. Usually Mercury retrograde for Sagittarius, I mean, it's not even really about people coming back so much as people testing our patience during that time, you know. And I always feel like Sagittarius has this tendency, especially during Mercury retrograde, to be like, you know, saying a whole lot more than maybe we should, you know what I mean? Sagittarius, I said what I said. So for me, it's a time where I'll usually kind of stay low, but I feel like for us and you know Aries season, you know things are going to move, Sag, going to move, mark my words, because I'm seeing it. It feels like. Okay, and I'm gonna take a lot of looks at April. Let me just say that because we are sick to death of sitting still, right? I'm gonna take a lot of looks at April. So this is just a few predictions, you know, with the tea leaf cards for and keep in mind this may be your message, this may not be your message, parts of it may be your message, and this is about April, okay? I was very specific in my wishes here. So I feel like you are definitely going to feel renewed in April. Yes. Yes, Sagittarius. Because happiness is here with flowers, which is really about blooming. And there's a lot of Phoenix energy here for you, I have to say. And victory. Happiness and victory. So you're definitely winning. I mean, are you winning over a particular situation? I think like what's happened here is that you're just walking away from things. Like we've spent the last few months just walking the freak away, right? Eight of Cups and kind of with the Death card too. They may have been things you didn't exactly want to walk away from. But things you knew you had to. And so really, do you have feelings attached to it? Yeah, because the Eight of Cups often, you know, yes, we are walking into better times and we are, you know, definitely leaving things behind that we felt very emotionally attached to, but we still have some level of feeling with it, you know. For me, the eights definitely are a start of movement, and it's where everything starts to pick up more speed, right? What's interesting here is literally one wand card. One wand card, because what I feel is happening here for you in April, Sag, is that things are happening, and it's not necessarily you making them happen. It's things happening. But I can tell you that it looks really good, if I can say that. And I feel like you're in a good space with what you've had to walk away from because you wanted real change in your life. And so real change has come. Okay, so with the Death card being here, this is like emerging totally different. Totally different. Maybe a whole new you, Sag. You know, but there was a heavy transformation which involved kicking some things to the curb. That's, you know, and I feel like it wasn't easy. I don't really ever feel like the Eight of Cups is easy. I will be honest with you. Those are things that we still feel something for, but we've kind of given everything that we could. And so, you know, this was definitely you in situation saying, hey, I've done all I can do here, and it's time for me to enact some changes in my life. And so, yes. So it involved a lot of letting go, but on the other side of it, there is happiness, Sag. There are things blooming. There's so much flowers here. Sagittarius, we have tulips and April's right in the middle of your reading. Let me just say that. Right in the middle. So, as far as I feel like some of you might be traveling. And if this isn't a physical travel, although I feel like it is, I feel like there's a return to passion for you, which is really beautiful. And that's what I mean by this may have just been your journey to call your power back, to return to passion. But I also feel sad, like in April, you may be feeling a lot happier than you had in the past. And this is because Sagittarius energy and moving forward, hello. And for some, you may actually be taking a trip as well. And if you're not, it might be something that you want to plan because there's a lot of rejuvenating energy here that would happen. And I feel really interesting that the Hierophant is here because I also feel like this is like this is so much a path journey for you. It really into what you value. It's a step into value. I feel like that's what's been central with leaving things behind. Really getting in touch to what's important to you. Right? And the Ace of Wands and the Sun, oh my gosh. Like you're about to be really happy. I feel like that's what's happening. I feel like you have left behind things that you no longer valued, or no longer valued you. There's a huge energy here about value and about, the Hierophant is also what learn. We become the student. And, we either become the student or we become the teacher. And I feel like here, this is what you're discovering. I mean, it's really the Ace of Wands is really feeling inspired towards moving forward. And this may happen with some sort of trip you take, Sag. So if you're thinking about it, even just a drive, because here's the carriage, a drive, and the sun is like, maybe you're spending time in the sun. Maybe the sun is connected to what you're doing, because there's enlightenment here about, your life path, your life's purpose, wow, it's like you're stepping into so much because with the sun of course is happiness. It is. But it's also like finally figuring out the direction that you need to go. There's that. And I'm telling you, and I don't know why I feel it like so intensely. I feel like there may be a trip involved, Sag. I don't know. Like, and for some, that could mean anything. I mean, you could go someplace different. It definitely has something to do with the sun. And I think if you do this, you'll find like ideas coming towards you and inspiration towards, what it is you really want to do. What your life purpose is, maybe. Because you're the student in this, you've learned a lot, okay? And you've learned a lot about moving towards value. Whether that's valuing yourself, right? But it's also, because I know I have felt this too. And I saw something recently about relationships, about how we can be totally different from the people that we connect to. But if we have similar value systems, that is something that you can build on. And I agree with that with life. Like we cannot like be with people or situations that we don't value and that don't value us. So I feel like you've really been getting in tune with what it is you value. And for different people, that's going to be different things. Sagittarius is a very spiritual sign. We're very much about growth. So if we are interacting with people who just are staying the same, even though we really care about them and they haven't per se done anything wrong to us, that isn't an energy we value. And so that may be something that is really happening in your life because there is this, lightning moment in which you say, oh my gosh, this is what I need to do. This is what I need to do because you have needed to return to a sense of inspiration, to feel inspired again. And of course, aces are new. Aces are new, so you may find that your values have really changed or that there's new things you want to go towards and feeling very inspired by them. Now, here's for some people, you're changing jobs. I said what I said. You may really like your job, but here's the thing. And this is very specific. If you have been dealing with a situation at work with someone who it's like they are in a position of authority, and I saw this in a recent reading I did. I think it was last week's money reading. You might want to look at that. And this is someone who very much I don't know, it's like they show up as the King of Swords reversed. They're manipulative. They always have to have their own way. They're like they've created a very hostile environment that, has become very difficult. And this may really have been a difficult decision for you, especially if you like your job. If you like your job, I feel like there's something happening here. And it could be a few things because I was hearing whole bunches of things. Like it says new job career. So for some people, that's what it's going to be for you, right? That you can't, like, you may have been waiting for the situation to change. And at one point, you just realize it's not changing. So I have to seek something better for myself. And there is it. But with the Ten of Cups being here, which is interesting, because I feel. If you've been dealing with this situation, something about it is going to have a big turnaround. Now, that could mean you move to a different department or you get a raise of some kind or a promotion, or you could totally just be getting another job. Something about the situation is turning around. And it does feel like this person, though, gets theirs. I'll be honest with you. It could just be that they get fired and all of a sudden your job is brand new. But there's definitely something big changing about it. And it directly has to do with this person who is very hard to work with, very mean, very, all about it's like that puffing their chest energy, right? They're all about being in charge, but they use it, to, I don't know, to not treat people well. So there's a very, it feels like a very hostile environment, but that is changing. Yay. And this is interesting. The most difficult part of a situation is over. And here's what's even more interesting, Sag. Do not be tempted to lower your standards. Beware of great pride. I feel it's so weird that the intuition I get off this. Like, I feel like if you have been, and we all are attracted to certain looks and things, and I feel like that might be something that you're overcoming, but. Here's the thing. This definitely would be for those who have left. It feels like old love behind, right? Because it definitely feels like you've been spending this time getting over something that definitely, abused your boundaries. And so this like time may have really been, you may have been spending a lot of time working on your standards, but I feel like the universe is telling you that in terms of your standards, there definitely is this need to not focus on how things look. I feel like this is pride. I really do, especially with Peacock. You know, but I do feel like you've been spending this time, especially if you had to let someone go, working on your standards. You know, I've done it. I have a whole like section in a journal about like, and not just what I expect from love partners, but what I expect from anyone who's in my life. You know, and of course you want to be careful when it comes to that, that you're being reasonable, right? I feel like that might have something to do with it too. But here's the thing, Sag. The Magician, the High Priestess, the Two of Cups, the Four of Swords, and the Ace of Cups. Like, this time has been really important to you. It's been important because it's allowed for you to develop these standards, you know, and to really look at everything. There's a strong, you know, going within energy here, especially with the High Priestess. The High Priestess, to me, is the Divine Feminine. And so really thinking about what you want to attract into your life, right? And not just thinking about it, being it, because we have to be what we want to attract. And for you, it's like you want a real spiritual connection. You want a deep connection. And, you know, I feel like this may have been a time of healing in which you thought about what your standards are. Where are you, like, even in terms of, you know, where are you letting people slide? Where have you let people slide? Or when is it that your pride interferes? You know, there's just a serious revamping of your standards here. And so going forward, you're not letting nothing slide. No, no, no. I will not reduce my standards. I will not settle, you know. And it's really been this sense of figuring out exactly what that is. And it's not that you don't accept the hard things or the things that are more ugly. No one's perfect, right? But there's a sense within you, for sure, you don't want to be aligned with people who aren't there to work things out. No. If we can't learn to integrate, especially if we're different, then I'm not going to do it. You know, I feel like you've really been thinking about it. And now, so intuitively, pay attention to your dreams, because it does feel like there's new love coming. And new love coming with this person that you've become, with your the standards that you've worked on, the healed version of you. That is what is coming in. Someone who aligns with you, Sagittarius. Yay. That's all I can say about that. You know, wow, look at this, Sag. Younger man shield. Oh, gosh, what is this? You may be getting intuitively a feeling that you need to protect yourself from a younger man. That's very specific. It's also telling you, wow, you may have discovered that someone was gossiping about you, but this is like, I feel like this is also telling you to be really careful who you talk about your new opportunities with. You know, be careful that they aren't people who run their mouth. I said what I said. I said what I said, Sagittarius. So for sure, you know, in the extended, I will look at this new love and this work situation. And yeah, although I feel like you already have a feeling about all of this, it never hurts to get a peek, right? But there's definitely a sense of things really moving. So yeah, we want to look at these new things now that you've put so much work into yourself, Sag. I love this. Love it. So let's see. Let's get a message to end with. See what April is teaching you. What is April teaching Sagittarius? These cards are a mess. What is April teaching Sagittarius? What's the lesson in April? What is the lesson in April? Oh, geez. Geez, Sag. Oh. I feel like you're learning to really feel differently about endings. It's like, okay, so universe, we're all just stardust and endings are inevitable. You may be feeling differently about endings because, you know, we're all connected and the ability to see yourself and others and to see that point of connection is really a miracle for your healing. And I feel like that's what you're being able to see. Now, that doesn't mean you don't have endings. You have them. You know, you're just returning that energy to the universe, though. Lovely. Start a revolution, and your potential is endless. Which is bringing people, Sagittarius. It's like you return people to the ethers with understanding, right? And you pull in people who are willing to go to war with you. Yes. I'm here for that, Sag. I am totally here for that. And that's all I have for you right now, Sag. Toodles, loves you.